All right, viewers, welcome back to Up and Live on your Hype TV. Listen, you have seen so many talented artists pass through thus far, but no, I believe I'm going to put it that we have history here. We have a legendary right here. We have what we call a landmark in the music industry right here. And I'm going to just give a special welcome to my beautiful Jessica Bangeni. Welcome to Jamaica. Welcome to Hype TV.
Thank you so much for having me at Hype TV. It is a great honor for me and the privilege to be here. And it always feels at home. Far away from home.
It certainly is far away from home for you, all the way from South Africa. Wow. I was also told that you also promote our Jamaican music and culture over there. How is that going?
We have always been inspired by the great Junior Balls. Mm-hmm. His songs kept our heroes and heroines on their toes during the times of struggle.
Beautiful.
Reggae music has been the passion, has been the soul that drove us now, to where we are today.
Thank you. Now, viewers, you may be wondering, boy, tell me more about this Jessica Bangeni all the way out of South Africa. I know you already know because you have been Googling, right? But of course, praise poet for Nelson Mandela, the former president of South Africa. Tell me a little bit, though, how did all of that came about, you being a praise poet?
A praise poet is the voice of the nation. Mm-hmm. We convey ancestral messages, divine messages,
right,
from God.
I was reading an article.
We heal the nation. We give the guidance,
right,
to our leaders. So from Nelson Mandela, Thabo Mbeki, Jacob Zuma, today we are speaking of Cyril Ramaphosa, that have just launched the manifesto of South Africa as we are about to vote in the few weeks' time. And all that lineage of the presidency, I have stood in front of them. I spoke words that were that I've conveyed from our great ancestors and the divine God.
Beautiful. Listen, Jessica is here in Jamaica. The whole world is turning their eyes for tomorrow night, which is going to be a big event right here. So we saw Ronnie Williams come alive. Claude Sinclair, welcome to Hype TV, by the way. I know you're the coordinator for the big, awesome, big 71 anniversary party. You need to tell the people about it.
Well, first of all, I want to thank Mr. Ewan Dawes and Hype TV for inviting me, inviting Jessica. Junior Biles, I grew up listening to the great sound of Junior Biles, Beat Down Babylon, A Place Called Africa, Fade Away, and Curly Locks.
Right.
And when I inquired about 2 years ago what really happened with Junior Biles, they told me that Junior Biles is not doing so well, mentally and physically. So I took my camera to his house as a vlogger, and I spoke with him for about 5 minutes, and I found out that Junior needs help. How can I help Junior Biles single-handedly?
Right.
So I spoke to his father, who is now deceased, and of course his sister, Janet, and they told me that they don't have that much money. When I checked the records, Junior Biles is responsible for over 40 hit songs. Beat Down Babylon, Curly Locks, mm-hmm. A Place Called Africa, and Fade Away are number one songs. And they're played in the dance hall every day as we speak. So what I did was I went to the Honorable Minister, Babsy Grange, and I told her of my intent to have a concert to raise funds for Junior. And she willingly gave us the Randy William Entertainment Center. So I want to say thank you very much, Babsy. Thank you so much for Junior and the family. And we said, how can we do this? We don't have any money to source this, and we need the greatest of the greats. So first we reached out to Jessica all the way in South Africa, because she's been to Jamaica more than one occasion. I produced a song, I'm in love with a Rastaman, with her and Raw Deal. And she quickly said yes. It cost her a lot of money. We also reached out to Aris Martin and Dark Eye Marshall and a whole lot of Half Pint and Eka Mouse,
right,
and George Nooks and Ken Booth and Raw Deal. And the artists keep coming and coming. Big U called me up, he needs to be on this show. Terry Ganzi called me up, I have to be on this show. Turbulence the Future is on the show because the heat is burning and we need to raise money for Junior.
Boy, tomorrow night seems to be rather promising. And it's the most opportune time because it is Reggae Month. It is Black History Month. And what other time to celebrate our people's life, you know what I mean?
Well, actually, Juno was actually born on the 2nd of February.
The Interesting.
Has never celebrated his life, never, ever gave him anything. We have to bigger people like Earl Chinna Smith, mm-hmm. who did a remarkable job, Muta Baruka, who did a remarkable job in sourcing funding for Junior and helping out for Junior. Mm-hmm. And we say, as a music fraternity, we must come together and protect and preserve our icon. We cannot have Junior walking the street, a man who has created hits after hits after hits after hits. A matter of fact, him walking the street, he got mugged and he lost sight in one eye. If we had preserved our artists and treat them with dignity and respect, they would have recognized Junior Baez and treated him with respect.
And I must commend you yourself, you know, Claude St. Clair, for taking up that baton, you know, going forward and getting the relevant persons on board. Thank you so much as well, Jessica, for coming all the way from South Africa to be a part of this remarkable event that will be held here. What's the cost for tickets?
Well, it's only $1,000. We wanted to keep it affordable.
Right.
$1,000 for our regular entrance and $2,000 for VIP. We want everybody to come out and enjoy. And a matter of fact, we have to be the former Prime Minister, PJ Patterson, who has bought 50 tickets just to come to the event, and he'll be in the house tomorrow night.
And the South African High Commissioner is coming,
exactly.
The whole entourage, and we've got a new High Commissioner on board, mm-hmm. who is very excited. She's coming with her entourage, and we will definitely be supporting the legacy of Junior Baez as the South Africa as a whole. And we hope to see you, Claude St. Clair, big stone man, come to South Africa, man.
Yes,
and the rest of Africa, so that we can spread the word for our legends and preserve our cultural intelligence, mm-hmm. and maintain our traditional protocols.
Well, that sounds good.
I just want to thank Mr. John Dawes for this quick, because it's a snap thing. We didn't plan this or anything, because we couldn't plan for Junior. Junior has been sick for over 40-something years, mm-hmm. with mental problems and so on. Not just Junior, Harold Butler, Ernest Wilson. We have some of our greats walking the streets. We should not happen. In China, they preserve the elders. In Africa, we respect and preserve the elders. In Jamaica, we must respect and preserve the elders that have paved the pathway for us.
Tell the people what time the gates will be open so that they can get themselves ready and out for the Ronnie Williams.
Well, we start early at 5:00.
Okay.
The gates are open. And by 7:00, we get down to Earl Chinna Smith playing with the Bingistra.
Okay.
You know, Earl is famous for producing Bob Marley and Dennis Brown and Jimmy Cliff. You know, so to have Earl Chinna Smith on board, it is an honor. I want to big up 92 from 90 Records, Winston Boswell, mm-hmm. who has given his support, and all the other sponsors who came on board to assist us, because we could not do this by ourselves.
All right. Thank you so much, Claude St. Clair. I want to just talk to Jessica just a little bit more, because, you know, viewers, we need to understand how far the culture goes and what the music industry involves. It involves a life. It involves persons who are empowered to making a difference in society. And I believe for being the winner of the South African Music Award for Best Traditional Album 2018 is certainly an accomplishment. And we from Jamaica want to say congratulations, Jessica.
Thank you ever so much. It feels good to be recognized for who you are authentically. Uthuzizo Jamaka sishathe ngqonqoli yakwambeki inhlamene kwelo khakhalongo vya kwamathiba umalale jongile mhlaqa magusha kwemelondo ekhaya. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the ones who have made it possible for the world markets to trade in gold, in diamonds, and the food our stomach still yearn. We've got our heritage intelligence.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, we need to use it. We need to be rooted, and we need not to be apologetic about who we are. So therefore, it's what I'm doing. I'm a philanthropist, I'm a humanitarian, I'm an artist, I'm an entertainer, I'm a custodian of my heritage.
Yes.
And I am recognized for who I am, from the multi Grammy award winning Soweto Gospel Choir founder, traveling the world in services. I was not only traveling to entertain the people, but I was researching, conducting a feasibility study. Ukuthi, what is feasible about we as the African people wherever in the world? Wherever we are, you can be in Jamaica, you can be anywhere. The world is what it is today because of the African people, because of our intelligence. Therefore, we need to celebrate. That's why I am here today, sacrificing the time with my children, with my family, with all the bookings and the gigs in South Africa, as it's a very peak. I'm in the peak season. We have been number 2 on iTunes.
Nice.
I think we'll be running for another Grammy, my darling.
Oh, jeez.
But
sounds good.
The most important thing is the spirit of Ubuntu, humanitarian.
Humanitarian.
Is nice. To recognize umuntu ngumuntu ngabantu. I am because you are. You are because I am. Yeah. Hence, I'm here tonight with Junior Bars on this eve, celebrating with him as we'll be taking him to his higher pedestal that he deserves.
And what can the Jamaican, the locals, the diaspora family who will be at that show anticipate from your performers?
Ooh, the collaboration with Radial, yeah, that has been trending, I think, in close to a million right now. Uh-huh. A song titled In Love with the Rastaman.
Oh, jeez.
And the new collaboration.
Hold it!
That will be performing for the first time with a great musician, Vanessa. Her father, I think she wrote, her father wrote songs for Jimmy Cliff, and there's so much legacy, mm-hmm, in this island, and I am still looking forward to meet the great artists Abu Abija and them that will be performing tomorrow.
Fine.
You know, my friends here in Jamaica
Paul
are like,
Elliot.
Hey, we see you with Abija, baby. We see you all the greats in Jamaica. We are coming with numbers.
Oh, wow.
I've got friends around. Don't take me for granted, baby.
I'm loving it. Oh, wow. Thank you so much, Claude Sinclair, for being here with us today. And thank you so much, Jessica, that's Bangeni, all the way from South Africa, for being on set. I look forward to your performance
you
tomorrow.
Are so profound, let me say. You are so profound. Thank you. Just a chat with you seconds before the interview.
Yes.
I'm telling you, you are going very far. Stay beautiful as you are.
Thank you so much.
She's,
you know, on that note, viewers, we're going to go to a short break. It's going to be commercial, but when we come back, certainly we have something else lined up just for you. Make sure you go ahead and support tomorrow at the Ronnie Williams Entertainment Center. That's the Junior Bars Benefit Concert, and it's also celebrating his 71st birthday, okay? We're going to a short break. We'll soon come.